Hi, this is Jaya. In this video, we shall see what Chaucer tells about the cook and the shipman in his The Prologue to the Canterbury Tales. Come, let's go to the tales. A cook they had with them for the nuns. That is, they also had a cook in the 29 pilgrims. And they had him so that he will cook for them for the occasion. To boil the chickens with the marrow bones, that is, you know, like that marrow bones will be there in the chicken. So to boil the chickens in a well nice way, and powder merchant tart and galangale is spices, and to powder whatever is needed for the tart and also the spices. Well could he know a draught of London ale, and this cook was a very good cook because he can find out the quality of a London ale. Ale is a drink. So by tasting the ale, he'll be able to tell you whether it's a best quality or not. He could roast and soot and broil and fry. So he can roast, he can make stews, and he can broil, and he can also fry. Make in mortars and well bake a pie. So he knew how to make stews and also how to bake a pie. But great harm was it, as it taught me, that on his shin a marmal had he. But here Chaucer says, I have something to tell you. There is a great harm, I think, because on his chin he had a sore. Actually, chefs must be very clean because they are cooking food for others. So when you have a sore, it is a sort of an infection. So that Chaucer mentions here. And then he goes on to say, from blank manger. Blank means white. Manger means pudding. So white pudding that made he with the best. And he's saying, but this cook was able to make the best white pudding. And then he mentions about the shipman. A shipman was there, weighing far by west. A shipman was there who came from the west. For aught I would, he was of Dartmouth. So he says he should have been from Dartmouth. Dartmouth is a place. He rode upon a roundsea. Roundsea is actually a cart horse, a horse which will not run very fast, which will just only walk and come. He rode upon a roundsea as he could, like, and he was riding because this is a shipman. So you cannot expect him to ride a horse like a soldier. So he was riding on a cart horse in a gown of falling to the knee. He was wearing a gown which was, the length was up to his knees. A dagger hanging on a lass had he about his neck under his arm adorned. And he was also having a dagger hanging in a rope, lass's rope, which was about his neck and under his arm. So he was having a dagger in that place. The hot summer had made his hue all brown. And since he is a shipman, he would have travelled to many places and he would have seen the direct sunlight falling on him. And this hot summer had made his colour brown. So he was fully tanned. And certainly he was a good fellow. And he says he is definitely a good companion. Full many a draught of wine had he drawn. And he's saying he has taken many draughts. Draughts means that barrels of wine from Bordeaux ward while that a chapman sleep. He had brought it from Bordeaux and he had brought it when the merchant was asleep. Of nice conscience took he no keep because he did not have good conscience. There was nothing to prick him bad. If he gets a chance, he'll take off the barrel of wine and walk out. If that he fought and had the higher hand, in case if we had to fight with someone and if he had won the battle, like he is fighting with another person and he is defeating him, by water he sends them home to every land. He will send them by ship or boat to their homeland. But of his craft to reckon well his tides, his streams and his dangers him besides. But about his skill, he knew well how the tide will go, like in which way the current of water will flow, his streams, where all he is traveling, the small streams, and the dangers him beside, and the dangers he will face in each place. Because in those days, when you're traveling by ship, you will have to be very careful. Many pirates will be there, many dangers are there, sudden storm may be there. So natural or man-made dangers are there. And he knew in which way, if he goes, he'll be safe from the dangers. His harbour and his moon, his Lord Menang. Here his harbour means he knew where is his place, where he has to travel. And his moon means he knew how to find the direction using the moon. And his Lord Menang means his the place how he has to navigate and go. There was none such from Hull to Carthage, hardy he was and wise to undertake. And he's saying there's no one who knew all the places from Carton. That is here, Hull to Carthage means, Carthage actually means Spain, another word for Spain. Hardy he was means he was very bold, and wise to undertake means he was also intelligent. With many a tempest had his beard been shaken. He has faced many tempests. Tempest means storm, which has shaken his beard means which was very frightful. He has seen many frightful storms. He knew all the heavens as they were, from Gotland to the Cape of Finistry. And he knew all the places, all the harbors. Here again, heavens means all the harbors, from Gotland to the Cape of Finistry. These are places. And every crack in Britain and in Spain. Every crack means inlets. Inlets means the sea flowing into the land. Small, small inlets it will be there. And he knew all the places, all the inlets which were in Britain as well as in Spain. His barge he clapped was the Madeleine. His barge means his ship was called Madeleine. You should remember the name of the ship because this can come in any competitive examinations. And this is what Chaucer tells about the cook and the shipman. If you have anything to add on to this, please write it in the comment box. Like the video, share it with your friends. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.